our final competitor. First place after the short program, Kaiya Ruiter, 14 years old, out of the Glencoe Skating Club, last year's junior Canadian champion, coached by Scott Davis, Jeff Langdon, and choreographed by David Wilson. Skating the free program here to Loyal, Brave, and True. Kaiya Ruiter from Alberta Northwest Territories, Nunavut. Look, this is a charming, beautiful young skater, just 14, junior champion last season. New program and a little bit of a new approach, a new style, and so it should be as Kaiya grows and matures and learns all different presentations of her style and a little stiff on some of the landings today. Beautiful stretch, beautiful flow. There's a look at the triple Lutz, Euler, triple Salchow. Stabilizes the landing. And the double axle, just a little stiff. You see, not a lot of knee bend on the landings, maybe just a little bit nervous, or you know, this is early on, this is over a month ago. There's the triple loop. But as in every program, there's something to be learned out of this. It's a beautiful emotional program. And it's a new, of course, there's the triple flip, triple toe a little bit later. She has such courage, she's not gonna back down on any of the planned elements. She's gonna go for it. That won't always work out, but in the long run, it will. We have some good talent here in Canada. We're seeing some really good skating. It's not that they always land all the elements perfectly. That's not the point. It's the overall skating skills, spinning skills, presentation skills there. And we definitely have seen that from a number of these women in this competition. And of course, tomorrow, don't miss the senior men. That was absolutely outstanding in the short program. Looking forward to that. That'll come up first thing tomorrow morning. We'll talk about that in a little bit. Kaiya Ruiter started skating at the age of 4, just 14 years old right now, grade 9 student, coached by Scott Davis, Jeff Langdon, David Wilson. Let's take a look at the spins. We have a change combination spin at 4, flying to spin at 4, layback spin at 3. Step sequence at 3 as well. Lots of growth yet to come in that new program, that new approach. It's beautiful. And when the skaters get on the ice and get enough training time, that'll be such a delight to see. The journey for all these skaters, it has to be hard. It needs to be hard because you don't get better without a challenge. It's a career of over 10 years in most cases to rise to the top. This was fun to watch and fun to be part of, and really interesting to hear the skaters' comments of sitting at home and knowing how you skated but not having any idea what scores you would get or how anyone else skated. So in some ways it's a completely different type of a competition and has its own value. Doesn't replace real competition by any means, but in some cases it might be a good application to the younger skaters. Lower the cost of competition for some competitions, not for all, for sure. Well, we want to thank all the officials who worked hard throughout the day in the junior and senior rhythm dance. And the senior women's event, 30 skaters in this event. We appreciate all the work that they've done, not only in being at this high level of judging, but really mostly learning the online scoring system and going through that extra training they needed to do to apply this in this competition. Of course, we thank Skate Canada as well for their efforts. We thank all the viewers as well. We had really large viewership during the whole day today, not only in Canada, but from around the world. Some beautiful stories coming from Ireland and in Europe. Some emails and text messages. We appreciate you joining the Skate Canada competition. Text message wondering from a viewer wondering how people get their medals if this is a virtual competition. It's a good question. Yeah, we will check that out. We think the medals will be mailed to the athletes. That's certainly what we've done here in British Columbia when we had a virtual competition. We announced it, of course, and we put it in the mail. So we'll find that out for you. how much fun will it be to watch Kaiya, Madeline, Emily, all the skaters over the next year or two or three or four, how many ever years they continue to compete as they grow and mature and improve. Sort of a new generation. And a big question, how will competitions in the future be run? Will, you know, even with COVID being in control, will competitions be slightly different? I don't know. Okay, the elements have been finalized. So judges just putting the scores in for the program components. Here's the score for Kaiya Ruiter. The free program, 100.26. That's seventh in the free program for 163.17. That puts Kaiya currently into fourth place.